friends and benefactors, on behalf of the children at Maithom, I would like to bring you these greetings from Maithom in Vietnam. I guess all of us have been through very difficult times because of COVID-19. I wish that all of you and your family are safe and happy and able to overcome some challenges if happen because of this pandemic that affect all of our lives. Yet in Maithom, we are very grateful with your help that we were able to sustain this difficult time. We still have 90 children living with us, and during the lockdown period, many people were affected by COVID-19. They didn't have a place to stay. Our shelter also opened to shelter them. We had around 10 people, mostly the old people and the homeless. Disabled people came to stay at Maithom together with the children. Also, after the lockdown period, Maithom also have the children collect things that they have and share to the people who are in need, especially the people from ethnic minority community. We were very happy and find the life very meaningful despite of many challenges came to us because of COVID-19. We have one child who is very sick. Couldn't respond to the treatment, and she's the last stage of AIDS, and we hope that she can survive. But we trust in the providence of God. Whatever happened, we try to provide the best care we can and hope that she will find peace, whatever happened to her life. We also have two new infants, newly born, came to Maithom. The mothers living with HIV and they have no shelter. And when they were referred to Maithom, they were taken care of, and now they deliver their baby. Their baby are healthy and also were prevented from HIV transmission. This is also the 15 years since the time Maithom started, from 2005, now 2020. And we also want to reassess all the stories of Maithom and see what we need to do to improve the quality of life of the children and to assure that the children can begin to start their own life without Maithom. Because many children already now in the university, some of them have gone back to the community, some who are now preparing themselves to be independent. Now we have a system of Montessori education. We send one staff to study this program and come back to have a special program for kindergarten children in the age from 3 to 5 years old. And we find it very helpful because the children become more confident, more independent, and they can take care of themselves well. We have some children affected by HIV in the sense that they had some disabilities mentally and also physically. And we also find a way to improve their life through the help of one Australian foundation called ASIF. They bring some expert in psychology, in mental health, and also in education to help us to reassess on the life of the children who are in need of a special education. And from there, we come up with a proper program that fit them. For those children in the community, we have now more than 200 of them. Those who are below 18 years old, we continue to provide educational support like tuition fee allowance and fees to go to hospital for treatment. With the mothers, we try to improve their life by have them train more in their skills of caregiving, especially for infants, caring for the children in need. So MyTam have gone through a lot of change in this year, despite of the problem of COVID-19. We try our best to reorganize the structure of the shelter so that it can run more smoothly, but address closely to the need of each member at the shelter. We are very happy that through your help, especially our benefactors from HOPE, from Little Hands Group, from Bridging Hope, from ASIF Foundation, and from many other benefactors from Boston, from Virginia, from California, and friends in the community in Vietnam. Each of you have helping us to live each day with hope and a joyful way. Life continues to move on, and we offer our prayer every day for all of us and for all of you who help us, who accompany us from afar. I'm very grateful for your kind support, for your concern, for your love in the past months and also from the beginning. And that kind of support really sustain us and give us hope in this difficult time. We wish you all the best.